big boy ever act up on you? Mine's been glitchy.
Austin got himself bit by a mole rat.
Hey, pal.
So now they got us picked up in here to watch Aaron.
You found him!
It's ridiculous.
Thanks, mister. I was so worried about him.
You're welcome.
I'm so glad he's safe.
Ashes! Bad kitty. I was so worried about you. And I bet Mom's gonna make me give you a bath.
You need a doctor. Forsythe and Rachel are down in the medical center. They can patch you up.
I know. I don't like it either. Back.
Remember, no funny business.
Where are the screws?
Work never ends in Vault 81.
You should stop by and see Horatio. Imagine you come across.
You have to do something, Jacob.
I'm running the test as fast as I can, Priscilla. I can't treat Austin until I know what he's infected with.
Dr. Forsythe.
Not now, Bobby. And you, stranger, will have to wait your turn. We have an emergency here. Austin got bitten by a mole rat. Isn't that enough, Jacob? There can't be that many mole rat diseases or toxins.
Rachel is examining the mole rat. Hopefully she'll find something, but these aren't ordinary mole rats. Who knows what kind of diseases they are carrying? Because he's just a child, it's affecting him more severely.
Dr. Forsythe, please! I think I found something that might help Austin.
Bobby!
Hold on, Priscilla. What is it, Bobby?
Well, you know that door Austin found? He found it because of me. I keep my private things in there. He saw me get them.
You mean your chems?
Get to the point, Bobby. What did you find in that place?
It's like a whole extra vault in there, but half ruined and caved in. There was this terminal there, so I started poking around in it. There were some notes and stuff about using mole rats to grow viruses. But they also said that they used them to make vaccines and treatments.
A secret vault? Good Lord, I've never heard of such a thing.
Bobby, you're a genius. A junky genius. There might be a cure for whatever Austin got from that mole rat somewhere in that place. You there. How would you like to do Vault 81 a favor and possibly save my boy's life?
I would be glad to help.
I was hoping I could count on you. Bobby here will show you where he keeps his secret stash. There is a chance that somewhere in there is a cure for Austin. If you find it, bring it to Dr. Forsythe. And for Austin's sake, please hurry.
Follow me.
Without that cure, Austin will certainly.
Thank you.
what you're doing there is gonna help.
Nice.
Well, that was a whole lot of nothing.
This is a lawful use of the power
source. Shoot out the power source.
That's it.
I can wave that sword! Now I feel cheated.
Loading me boots. We being followed.
Oh no, you...
I'm sure this whole thing is overblown and Austin will be running around tomorrow.
Overblown or not, we have to do what we can for Austin. I just don't know what I can do.
Neither do I, Priscilla.
Why him? He's just a boy.
He's going to be just fine. You'll see.
Baltac. Making the perverts look like saints.
Just garbage. I toss it.
Well, this is gonna be a joy for you. You get to nag me and I can't go anywhere.
Oh, real nice, Holt. Make this about you.
Someone thinks of anyone other
than your daughter can get sick like Austin, and you're whining about spending time with your family?
I have things to do. We don't have to hide away in here.
You're so busy, Holt. You have so much to do. Please, explain to Aaron why your needs are more important.
I'm gonna rip your limbs off.
You know how to show a girl a good time.
You and your staff are to make sure every resident remains under stringent medical observation.
Understood. But, Overseer.
No buts. This is for the good of the Vault. We can't risk this pathogen spreading, Dr. Forsythe.
Yes, Overseer.
How is Austin doing?
Not good. The infection has progressed quite rapidly. We need a way to stop it from spreading.
Then let's hope that outsider pulls through and gets us a cure.
shite! What happened to them?
Got it.
I detect intruders. Please neutralize them.
Did you see that? Good. Thought it was me. Making me feel like a jilted lover.
I detect intruders. Please neutralize them.
We keep the vault safe.
Are you Vault-Tec Security? I've waited so very patiently for you to arrive.
Who the heck are you?
I am a Contagion's Vulnerability Robotic Infirmary Engineer, or CVR-IE. The human scientists call me Curie. Or more properly, they call me this when they were alive. I repeat, are you Vault-Tec Security?
These mole rats carry a disease. Do you know anything about it?
My poor little darlings. They were used to grow all manner of new and interesting pathogens. Then Vault citizens would be exposed to these viruses in the hopes that they would develop new antibodies. But they never got a chance to execute their plan. Clyde got out of his cage. He was smarter than the others. My sweet Clyde. He let out the others, and those poor scientists never stood a chance. Clyde's been dead for almost 2 centuries now, but his descendants have free run of the vault. I'm rambling. Where are my manners? Are you Vault-Tec Security?
Yes. Yes, I am.
Superb! I placed an emergency call so long ago, I was beginning to think something dreadful must have happened. I am pleased to report I completed my primary duties 83 years ago. Thousands of pathogens were grown in the mole rat hosts. Then, a single broad-spectrum cure was developed to treat them all. Very satisfying work for many decades. Now, please tell me you are authorized to release me from the lab.
I am so authorized. You are released.
Superb. I had almost given up all hope of living here. I'll open the door for you. Since you are a Vault-Tec representative, I entrust you with the broad spectrum cure I developed. If you have an equivalent to my digital Hippocratic Oath, please use it quickly to prevent any undue suffering. However, be advised, there is only one dose left, and I can no longer make any more. If that is all, I am most eager to leave.
You only have one dose?
That is correct. There used to be more, but they all expired. Sadly, the organic compounds necessary to make more have all deteriorated.
Thanks for the cure.
It is my hope that this cure finds its way to someone who needs it. Hopefully now I can properly further my scientific research. Since my job here is done, I think I will follow you out. much to learn and see.
Don't try anything.
You should stop by and see Horatio while you're here. I imagine you come across many barbers in the common park.
It is good not to be stuck in the quarantine. Something.
You got guts wearing that pit boy in the Commonwealth. I can't believe someone has.
Hey, hold.
I hope you don't have anything that needs fixing. I really don't feel like working.
Priscilla. She's worried sick. She's barely eaten or slept since it happened.
Excuse me, Overseer.
Kids and their curiosity. Damn that Bobby DeLuca. I can't believe this happened. Dr. Forsythe is doing all he can, but we're not sure it's gonna be enough.
A routine analysis of you indicates you have suffered very little from radiation. Curious.
Damn it. You should see Dr. Forsythe. I heard he has a job for you.
Hello, Dr. Forsythe.
The cure. You found it.
How is Austin doing? Do you think he'll survive the cure?
He's been unconscious since shortly after you left.
Here, take the cure, and use it on the boy.
Only one dose?
I hope this works. If it doesn't, there won't be anything to analyze to try again.
Let's hope this works.
I heard you had returned.
It shouldn't be long.
Where am I? You're in the clinic.
You were really sick, Austin. Our visitor from the Commonwealth saved your life.
Really? Gee, thanks, mister.
I was worried to death about you, Austin. What got into your fool head, going into a place like that?
Nothing exciting ever happens here. I just wanted to see what was in there.
Well, if it hadn't been for our friend here, you might have died. Thank you. I know you made sacrifices to help him. I know Dr. Pinsky will be grateful. For my part, I'd like to give you the syringer. I had it for years and never really had a use for it.
She's not the only one. The whole vault is thankful. I'd like to give you a room here in the vault. A place you can call your own. It's in the main hall, on the left as you get off the elevator. Once again, thank you.
Can I go see
I hope you enjoy your accommodations. I wanted to say thank you again for what you did for Austin. You've opened a lot of eyes around here. I had no idea of the dangers Vault Tech had hidden away so close to home. I can't believe so many died just behind our walls.
What do you know about Vault Tech?
I'm afraid not much. I've spent my entire life being thankful for the Vault, for the walls that protected us over two centuries. But not once have I had contact with them.
If Vault Tech had lived to go through with their plan, this place would be wiped out.
I don't doubt that one bit. I hate to think of what they had planned for us. But on the good side, you made a real impression on our anti-Commonwealth people. They're realizing outsiders really can be trusted, and do more good than just providing resources. You'll always be welcome here, and I hope you make a habit of visiting. Having a trusted outsider would help serve as a reminder that the Commonwealth isn't something to fear and avoid.
Ah, the dangers of curiosity.
A moment, please.
Lucky for Austin,
I have been trapped so many years. I believe it's customary to thank you for your role in saving me. My entire life has been in this vault. I have analyzed and learned everything there is to know here. So now I must see the rest of the Commonwealth, consult with scientists, unearth more data to challenge my hypothesis.
It sounds like the vault could really use you.
Of this, there is no doubt. But I seek to elevate my capabilities, and down here I will stagnate. I can see you already have company. I do not wish to intrude, but I must ask. Please, monsieur, can you take me with you?
Maybe later.
Well, perhaps for now I will help out here. But if you change...
People here will never forget what you did for us.
You need a doctor, Forsythe, and Rachel.